Dimitrov to begin. When you have suffered defeats, Nico, like he has, how important is the start of this match, do you think, for Grigor to build a little bit of belief in there?
That's why I mentioned that he needs to get to the end of this set without dropping the serve. At the very least, so the pressure mounts on an opponent that has really beaten you. The only time Dimitrov beat Zverev was the first time they played back in 2014. Since then, five straight wins for the German. Just so solid from the back forehand and backhand. He's been hitting a clean ball again, and he said in the press conference after the first round match that he feels he's on his way, not quite there yet, but he will be competing for the top spot in the rankings in the near future again. Well, that was inviting. The Dimitrov forehand, as you say, has beefed up a little this year, hasn't it? They've been looking to get that shot into play a little more often. Enable him to dictate when the opportunity presents itself. That's a first serve in the opening game. A sign for that going forwards. Been a while since Grigor won a title, isn't it? I know that's something that the team have been looking at. Got to go back to 2017, the last time Dimitrov won a title. That's 6 years. That's a very long spell, isn't it, Nika, for someone of his quality?
He's been around for a long time, and there is Dani Valverdu from Valencia to Venezuela. And Grigor's corner again. He started traveling as a coach with Andy Murray. Worked with a few other players and is currently with this man. Also, the tournament director for the Washington, D.C. event. First year director for that.
Yeah, must
give a week.
Yeah, sorry, Nick. I must give an honorable mention to my good friend as well, Jamie Delgado, who of course does quite a few weeks out there.
Yeah,
he did the North American swing this year. A lot of the weeks in Monte Carlo as well. Shared job.
Remember when he started working with Jess Green, who worked with Andy Murray before, he said it was a 3 to 4 year period to get Zverev physically ready to compete for the top gig. Jess did an unbelievable job. This guy is a monster. So he uses his legs to get up for that serve. one of the best first serves in the business. Issues with his second, though, when things get tight.
Yeah, that's been a regular pattern, isn't it? There's Dad, the player himself, years ago now. Block returns. That's going to be key tonight, isn't it? Neutralize that first serve. Has done a decent job of getting it low.
Maybe an advantage for Dimitrov in terms of hands, but Zverev has gotten a lot better getting close to the net to finish that one. And at 6-6, it's a tough proposition to pass him on the sides. Huge wingspan for the German. Low. That gave the chance to Dimitrov to hit a ball shoulder height in the next shot and hurry up Zverev to the side. That's exactly what he's looking for.
First percentage to Zverev. Look through his numbers across the season. Generally in the sort of high 60s, early 70s, isn't he? Got a bit of height as an advantage, of course, but always a case that they go hand in hand. Testing hold. And the German comes through it.
One game first set.
Some changes behind the scenes, haven't there? Of course, his physio, who was with him for many years, Hugo, has actually moved across to work with Felix Auger Aliassime. So there's been a couple of changes behind the scenes.
But the musical chairs have always worked, especially among Europeans. They tend to keep the same sort of people around. But certainly for a lot of the people that travel with Zverev, like this young man, Mr. Melo, ex-number one doubles player in the world. He's constantly at Zverev's side. Has proven a bit taxing to travel with Zverev. Papa, always a fixture.
There's the danger, Nico, of actually overplaying that slice, isn't it? Because you can see here, he's actually just sitting here waiting for this one.
Yes, but I like the one up the line right here. Too comfortable for Zverev, and with that long arm and the whipping forehand, he can produce tremendous amounts of power.
Yeah, the average ground stroke speeds for both coming into this match off the forehand side. Dimitrov actually just shy of 80 miles an hour in his first two rounds. To make an early move. Zverev instantly off that forehand side, very similar, 77, so there's not a lot in it in terms of that forehand pace. Pressurizing the backhand side. May not be the last time we see that play from him. It's Zverev that grabs the break. Yeah, if you look through the two previous matches, and we were talking about it early on in terms of how many times Dimitrov's broken Zverev. He's only broken him twice in five sets of tennis this year. So, need to improve on that, one suspects.
But then you see, if he goes cross court with the backhand slice, Zverev feels comfortable hitting inside out and just keeping the pressure. But if Dimitrov does the up the line backhand, that the ball stays low, look, he gets a pop up from Zverev and then has an open shot inside out inside the court. That's what he needs to look for, but it's not easy. And that's the one. He, you know, it's tough to pass off the one-handed backhand.
13-15.
With a good approach from Zverev this time.
Yeah, the sixth time he's been in already. Going to take those opportunities to get in.
There's that Dimitrov forehand that needs to work for him today.
30.
very solid. Let's go.
Can be a dangerous approach, that kind of from that part of the court. If you're going up the line, you've got to leave yourself quite a bit of exposed. Was the message. He did just that.
Bit of a game of cat and mouse here with the Dimitrov backhand, trying to keep it low to his very forehand, make him feel the pressure of the situation playing on a big court. Remember, Zverev out since Roland Garros 2022 with that horrible accident. Came back at the beginning of 2023. Dimitrov trying to make experience count here.
Do head to usopen.org if you haven't so far. All the scoring, the highlights, stats, all the draws are on there for you to have a look around.
15.
Season. I'm sure it feels like a long time ago now, but
the eye off the ball was looking to see where his opponent was when he had an easy ball to put away. You see the net points one, Zverev crowding the paint at the start of this one.
Great
job.
lot of extended rallies already, haven't we? It's not even five games in.
For services.
It's a winner point behind his second serve, 0-4. He's able to get some good depth on it.
14-13.
Dimitrov really got himself in trouble here with the double and that missed volley and trying to dig himself out of it here. Stay on serve.
Yeah, I think the team have been very keen to get him to control proceedings with his forehand, Dimitrov, when he gets the opportunity, as was the case there. That is naughty. What a wonderful volley. And the Bulgarian is back in front in this opening set. A good job, haven't they, here, enhancing this facility as well.
That's it, rip. The field.
Love 15.
That Dimitrov breaking Zverev back might have struck a chord in the German's confidence. All of a sudden, not hitting the ball so crisp as he was in the first two, three games.
Wins this year as Zverev, and we talked about where he was in the race. He's actually ninth in the race, so he's put himself in a good position. Dimitrov 18th in the race this season, so he's also above his ranking.
Season coming up, he loves to play.
Has he lowered the ball toss?
Yes.
Do you think he's lowered the ball toss a little bit, Nico? To me, it looks like he has.
Looks more compact, more in control.
Yeah.
Yes, definitely.
Just a slightly faster, isn't it, in terms of the motion.
Thank you.
cautious with the serve. He was just losing the rhythm on the serve. He was throwing the ball so high that then he had to wait with the leg. So I think that was a smart way to solve it. Trying to lower the toss to make it more compact and that way less room for error.
First serve so far, Zverev. Making life difficult. Here is that serve. Just gets up quicker, doesn't he? Well, he was maybe a couple of years ago. Emotional win in Hamburg for him. He actually said it felt like his first title again, winning in Hamburg. It must be pretty special to win in a town you were born.
Nothing like winning at home.
Title number 20 it was of his career. He's accumulated quite a few. Miles an hour.
And he got a great kick away from his opponent.
It made it.
Oh, it looked wide. The confirmation here in a second, but you could see the line as the ball was bouncing. Useful thinking there.
mention the fact he's actually served over 350 aces on the season, Dimitrov, which if you look through his numbers year by year is a high number. Maybe a little more pop on it, going for a little more as well.
I think that has been the key.
Again.
He's a guy looking for his 400th career win here tonight.
That's right, in the trough.
As effective with the serve as he was in the two previous rounds, so Dimitrov here has a chance and another loose error by Zverev to start off the game.
Yeah, 9 unforced for the German, 5 so far for his opponent.
First one of those is quite committed to. Just decelerated a touch, didn't he? See Danny Valverde being very vocal, try and get his man to stay in it intensely. Senior, you saw Sasha looking towards his corner and it gets some encouragement.
Serve.
that play with the slice up the line to this very forehand, but I feel Dimitrov needs to mix it up a bit, not hit all slices as Zverev got a hold of that one.
He just waited for the right ball, didn't he, the German? Just waited for the ball that was there to go after.
Well, in the last Dimitrov service game, he hit one very similar but missed at 15-30.
On the forehand, and it kind of seemed to force Dimitrov to take it on. It was a little rash. Quite taxing, can't it, as well, when you are having to hit against the slice a lot, Nico. You've got to work yourself, you've got to bring a lot of the racket head speed yourself, you have to do a lot of work when you're hitting up against the slice a fair bit.
Totally agree with you.
Generate a lot of your own pace.
To the high back and gets the short ball, but Dimitrov on the run with the squash shot. What an athlete this guy is. Great hands.
Thank you.
To go with it.
Moment of genius.
Good start for Grigor Dimitrov, holding firm.
And sneaking his way ahead again as we reach the sharp end of set number one.
Games, he did it with a slice just a few minutes ago. This time he goes over it. Just not enough on the approach. My Zverev gives Dimitrov a look at it.
There's a look as well as someone who was beaten by a pretty good shot. Still serving at 80% first serve, Nico.
Yes, but he was a lot higher in past matches, only 58% of the points with the first serve, and you have to give credit to Dimitrov in that department. He's bunting it back, putting the ball in play, and not making many errors.
For the ball, if they can keep him here in New York.
You like that?
Yeah, I do. Why not? Breakdown of the rally length by Hawkeye. We've had 15 rallies. Nico, right on cue as we look at the rallies overnight. 17 rallies over nine. That's a reflection of the sort of tennis we're seeing out here. Chip a little deep to try and deal with it. It's been a good contest this so far, isn't it?
Nice contrasting styles. I like the Dimitrov way of thinking. I'm trying to get to Zverev with the slice backhand. Zverev was crisp at the start, then had a little dip in his level, and I just feel that that last game, he hit the ball quite well.
Do you think it's a more important first set for Dimitrov to win than Zverev?
Totally. Him being the underdog in the match, I feel, is definitely more important.
Thank you.
the beauty of the 3 out of 5 contest that gives it an extra spice at the majors.
Just ask Laszlo Zverev about that.
Just a bit short with the change of pace there for Zverev, and El Dimitrov manages to get out of the way of the ball, and then flying on the other direction, hits a beautiful inside-out shot. Don't try this at home, folks. Look at that. From behind the baseline.
The last two majors. Almost lost to Holger Rune at Wimbledon. It was Zverev that beat him in the French. Djokovic got him in the third round in Australia this year. And we are one game away, one hold away from a first set breaker in one Armstrong.
First, but Grigor manages to break right back. So mentally, that was a big blow for Zverev, and the fact that now that this will be decided in a breaker, Zverev holds, I think Dimitrov has to be happy with it. Now it's just a matter of making the shots.
Turns is Dimitrov, but it's a rare free point for the German. Didn't he do well?
13-15.
Grigor has played the reaction points very well, using those prodigious hands of his.
So tiebreak it is. Tiebreak records this year are interesting because they're identical. 12 and 12 for both players in tiebreaks this season.
That's surprising. You would think the players ranked higher would have a positive comparison in the tiebreak.
Dimitrov, of course, winning a big one in that fifth set in the first round.
Here by Zverev and Dimitrov with the slice cross-court backhand winner. It's not a drop shot.
Dimitrov digging in.
It's for his side kit on the red hat. Second row. Reverse agent. So he gets the first mini break here. Working hard, both guys.
Does push the boundaries, doesn't he, in that regard? And Jaime Campestol has issued a yellow card.
Dimitrov with the double mini break here.
Went for the safe option with the volley, didn't he? And Dimitrov was waiting for him.
There, Zverev just looking as though he wanted to get out of that pattern, wasn't it?
Feel the tension in Zverev. He could not pull away from a guy that has been dominating. Big hole here.
Rally length, I can tell you, I've just been told, since the 10th game is 10 shots is the average rally length. That is,
you would think it would play to Zverev's advantage. Yeah.
Back. He's only ever won one set against Zverev in the last 10 that they've played. So it's been pretty one-sided. It's a good position to double that tally here. Out, but 100% in. And it's 4th ace.
And he's played a tremendous set. And a set that is within the cusp of taking. Who's in front? He leads Sasha Zverev, 7-6.
Day and night, completely the opposite.
Alexander Zverev to serve.
90% slice backhand from Dimitrov in that first set. 90% topspin from his opponent.
I'd like to see Dimitrov double that 10%, hit over the ball a little more. But it worked for him in that first set. Great tiebreak. A little down. See how Zverev bounces back.
Do you want to see from Zverev, Nico?
That one. Play backhand to backhand, and then when you switch over to the forehand, I feel that's Dimitrov's hole in terms of defense. Switch fast to the forehand, and when you come in, try not always coming into the backhand. I think Grigor is waiting for that one, maybe vary a little bit. And remember at the start of the first set, Zverev was coming in a bit more? I think he stopped doing that. Zverev 10 out of 21 in that first set. He was much more effective at the start of the set than he was at the end.
I just wonder if that pass that Dimitrov made, that outrageous pass, kind of just deterred him a little bit, I don't know.
Thing with strategy, sometimes you can discuss all you want before you go on the court, but remember Mike Tyson said that when you get punched in the mouth you forget everything. Well, maybe that's what happens. So players tend to go back to their tendencies. Zverev may be playing a little bit further back, Grigor may be slicing a little bit too much. That's what coaches need to do, remind their guy what they need to keep doing, stay with the strategy or change it if need be.
Iron Mike was here, wasn't he? On the opening night, I believe.
Came to watch from.
Daughter's a good player, isn't she, I think? Is this tennis?
Played down in Florida in Boca, in Everett Academy.
Girlfriend watching on.
14-15.
Just got himself out of position, didn't he, Dimitrov? Recover it.
mention the fact that Dimitrov going for his 400th win tonight. There haven't been too many players, certainly in recent times, that have achieved that. Active players, you know, likes of Fanini, Nishikori, Isner, of course, who's just retired, Morfis, over 500. Verdasco, still playing, 559 for the Spaniard. Vavrinka, Cilic, Gasquet. Murray, Nadal, and Djokovic leading the way at
15.
That's the stratosphere.
Yep.
Both Nadal and Djokovic over 1,000. Crazy. Dimitrov currently 12th. At least. He's been at it for a while.
13.
Season of his career, Dimitrov, in terms of match wins. Came, of course, in 2017, that remarkable year when he ended up winning the tour finals. 49-19 he was that season. That was a heck of an effort. There were a few players out injured, and perhaps truth, but.
Good return there by Zverev. Grigor stays way down, follows through, stays with it for the hold. Stuff after a set that grueling, an hour 10 to keep the intensity up. That's exactly what needs to worry Dimitrov right now.
To try and pull off that pass, couldn't really hit the slice from that far back either, so had to kind of take it on.
Thank you. 15-15.
Dimitrov's kept that to a very tidy number, isn't he? Just 10. Well, considering playing an hour and 22, it's good going. They don't come back very often. And it's ace number 7 for the German. Maintains his lead on serve in the second.
But center. Good hire in Darren Cahill, playing some exceptional tennis at the moment.
So I'm probably just forgetting that we have a change of balls here, aren't we? He's got his maths all tied up.
With that 14. Very disciplined effort, towing a fine line between being consistent but staying aggressive.
Good job, isn't he? All departments.
USOpen.org. Don't forget to go and take a visit. Plenty of good shopping to be had on there as well if you like your merchandise.
Thank you. this is so good. And he's got the game plan, he's got the execution spot on.
Yeah, watch out if you're Zverev. Dimitrov kept the level of intensity and now executing a lot better with the forehand, feeling confident. Look at the depth on this one, and then leaning back, manages to hit the winner cross court with a beautiful angle, short into the service box.
That's a good thing because he was there, wasn't he?
A bit of disappointment. Zverev's body language all of a sudden not standing straight up. He's slouching a little bit.
Just that contact point is so low constantly for him, isn't it? On that backhand side, he's it's not where he wants to be hitting the ball from, quite simply. Really big opportunities here for the Bulgarian to stretch his lead. Lighting things up here in New York, and he's got himself a set and a break lead.
And by what set to love? Take your seats quickly, please, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. Time.
Well, they're enjoying themselves. I'm not sure Sasha Zverev is, though, at the moment.
Thank you for your cooperation. Please, players are ready.
Full house virtually on Armstrong tonight. High profile match. So far, so good for the 19th seed. Can he maintain it? That's the question.
Once again, it's being able to see now as quickly as possible.
Something you see much of these days.
15.
Well, as you said earlier on, he's kind of stopped coming forwards, isn't he? On those sorts of balls. A little more reluctant to. For a couple of good passes.
Hard top spin forehand, masterful by Dimitrov up to this point.
Yeah. Just seemed to rush the approach, didn't he?
14-15.
Dimitrov has been the king of the intangibles out here. Louis Armstrong, just look at that get. Comes back with the slap shot. With the practically open court. With the miss, Dimitrov just flying to it.
String's gone, isn't it? Oh, look at that.
He just changed racket for a fresh one 2 games ago. Wonder what happened there. You just don't see broken strings anymore because players at this level, and there it is, it broke at the top, so maybe they hit it against the ground.
It's like a hybrid, doesn't it?
Just not normal.
Natural gut in there, was it, maybe?
Half and half.
Yeah, look that way.
You have connections in that camp. You should ask.
Zverev.
What a point.
by both guys. Zverev making Dimitrov hit a very tough ball right behind him, and no chance there. And it just seems like Zverev is casually waiting for his time in this match with a huge opportunity here.
Mum at the back there, just with the blonde hair.
She's been living this match intensely.
And there she is, just in the cardigan on the right-hand side. Dimitrov's mum. His dad was the one that introduced him to tennis, wasn't it?
To let that ball bounce, but decided kind of late.
That's a tough shot to take on, isn't it?
And stop right before you touch the net.
Exceptional ball, he's missed it. I thought he'd made it. That's a big game to get through.
Dimitrov wins 4-2. Second set.
Growing the belief, isn't it?
Dimitrov is everywhere tonight. absolutely enfuego in all departments. Look at the athleticism and right on top of the net to put that away. The slip here in the back of the court by Zverev. Dimitrov making sure his opponent is okay, but what a show of athleticism by Grigor.
I'm going to mop a little bit of sweat up here, I think. Yeah. This used to be a time when the ball boys and girls would do that, but that's changed now. Just got to make sure that the perspiration's off the surface. Dimitrov's just been relentless this evening. There's been no drop at all, Nico, has there? Of any kind, really.
Because when Dimitrov got 14, up to 15. His high ranking of number three, it was a combination of great athleticism, raw power, especially on his serve and shot making ability. But this performance up to this point today, it's been very shrewd, very smart, very disciplined.
Reduce the arrears.
38 mph
first serve. That was big. Oh. So there'll be a few people at the beach. Who knows? If they're not at the tennis.
Thank you.
With the little steps, getting right on top of that ball with the forehand, staying aggressive. Heard Danny Valder do there, tell Grigor just to keep the good energy. And that's been the theme of the match for this man, going on almost 2 hours.
He's talking on the serve in terms of just keeping that balance. It's been something they've been working on. Body serve I've seen right through him. was only 121 miles an hour. I say only, but of course Ben Shelton rolled one in yesterday at 147 miles an hour.
Fair physically for Dimitrov, and you wonder if he has enough to stay with Zverev. Shall the German win this second set? But that's still to be decided, as we're only back on serve after that break. Things are getting interesting.
Second time the Dimitrov serve's been broken. Much about momentum, isn't it? When you've got it, you ride with it. It's so important that Dimitrov can just try and find a way to recover here.
And all of a sudden, Zverev is not missing much and just moving Dimitrov side to side.
There's a little look at the last 10 points. German was looking for here. Quick hold. Put the pressure right back down the other end. Swung his way first here. He leads 5-4 in the second. Yeah. Dimitrov serving to stay in the second. Oh.
Grigor needs to progress. Because Zverev, down is setting a break, gave no signs of desperation, just kept going at it until he got the break back the last game and won an impressive and imposing service game to go up 5-4.
Just came out of that one a bit.
13-0.
Can't get his weight behind it. First serve percentage in a good place, isn't he? He's the fastest serves, but Dimitrov's up in the mid-60s still. It's dropped at times against some of the better players this season. So a slightly more number that's more vulnerable for it. Very cute. Dimitrov.
Five games.
Swift hole.
Second set.
Hello. They don't age, those two, do they?
Timeless wonders.
That's very cool. I've had a good day. Sorts of rallies have we seen Dimitrov emerge from? Yeah. Really well, didn't he?
He has better hands than Zverev. You saw that there, the quick flick of the forehand, not this one, the one coming up right here, fooling Zverev, just not enough time to react. He was late.
Thank you.
To that last volley.
Quality point. Things up once more.
The crowd on fire out here on Armstrong. These 13. Guys, this defensive love. Zverev doesn't do enough with it, and great job by Grigor keeping
Thank
that
you.
Ball low. Taking full advantage of that one. Full pressure on his opponent.
to you.
Was it the right shot? It didn't miss by much, did it? It's another rally that's gone beyond 20. It's been very much a match play in that style, isn't it? So many long rallies we've had. Emphasized by those numbers. Doesn't do enough after a good first serve. Pays the price. Damn, how good is that chip return there, Nico? It's been so valuable just to keep the ball low on him, isn't it? And allowed him to be quite as aggressive off those shots. And this man was there again. Break point. Second deal. Maybe caught a Bulgarian out.
Of the difficulty, because of the stage of the match that we're at, you get a feeling there is a premium on this set particularly. What a volley. Had those slightly bigger swings on the forehand side in particular, isn't it? It's quite a significant take back. I think he's just got a step too far here. Uh-oh. Interesting. So I was just asking if he can use the VAR to have a look at it. Maybe we'll get a replay of where Dimitrov was when the time violation was called, because that would be revealing. Sometimes these things can change the course of a match. It's a crucial state.
right here, and he only had one serve. Letting his emotions be known. But clearly.
May have put some extra fire in his belly. Forced to take up quite a lot at the end of it.
15 love.
So disciplined tonight, Dimitrov.
It's been beautiful. Been awesome tennis from the get-go. Really enjoying this one. Like a cat.
Yeah, I mean, he's lost his balance completely here, and yet he's still got the ability to turn and deliver that from a deep position. Cat. Exceptional game from the Bulgarian, you have to say.
Six
we are into a second successive tiebreak.
Tiebreak.
This has been a great level, Nico, isn't it?
It's just beautiful to watch the way Dimitrov has carved out this match with that backhand slice. Zverev staying cool and calm when he was down a set and a break, managed to break back. And, wow, so much riding in these next few minutes. Grigor going into the first tiebreaker. Zverev, having broken back late in this set, I feel has a bit of an emotional upside coming into this one.
Oh.
Delivers
Dimitrov.
Performances in terms of passing shots that I can remember from Dimitrov, and I've been watching him for over a decade.
One of the benefits of being such a good mover is that he actually doesn't have to overcommit, does he? He can kind of hold his position and then go. Straight through. These two have already been on court well over 2.5 hours. Serve, didn't he? To good effect. Dip on it when required.
To that one, but just an easy put away. Zverev.
Thank you.
to believe it's such a decisive moment in the breaker that off his most trusted win, he'd miss one. Very unusual. Chance for Bulgaria to move ahead by two sets to love. Armstrong right now. This match is delivered in every sense.
Just does not do enough with that one. Got there comfortably. Made the wrong choice.
Set point for the German. This tiebreak could prove to be. He's invested so much in this match as Dimitrov. Full commitment to the forehand.
Seven. Dimitrov.
He's happy again.
Goes away down set point.
had to wait a fair bit for the ball to get there.
Too many seconds, is he, tonight, especially under this sort of pressure. What a brilliant change-up. The German able to outmaneuver Dimitrov for once. This has been an incredible wake-up. Second chance for Zverev to draw level. Is Zverev responds by taking the second set in the breakout.
Considering how grueling these 2.5 hours have been for this man, Dimitrov has had to do most of the running up to this point.
I wonder if they'll actually consider moving that match, because obviously there's been a fair bit of press, isn't there, this year, negative press with matches starting late, and Von Drusen is not going to walk on court till probably the earliest midnight, right? I mean, it could be even a possibility they might move it, right?
Well, you do the math, and it's 2.5 hours, and this could go on for another 3 sets.
Yeah.
And the first two lasted, you know, as long as they have. Feeling they will not.
15-0.
You never know. It'll take something special out of this man.
They've actually just been told that all courts are closed. All outside courts have been closed. So they will be on here regardless. You've got to think about the crews, haven't you, who man the courts. They've got to be kept here as well. It's not just a case of keeping all courts open. It's not as simple as that. A few factors that come into that decision.
13-14.
Good opening game is for Dimitrov. And he's under some pressure already.
Sophia.
Dimitrov is broken. The pressure grows on him. Don't forget, of course, Dimitrov was down match points, wasn't he, in his first round to Alex Molchan.
Didn't come in with a whole lot of confidence into this one, but boy, he played well against Andy Murray in his next match.
Yeah. Slower second serve, catching him out. Mental test is for Dimitrov, isn't it now? Resilience does he have? What grit is there within him to make a recovery?
Defending in great fashion. You get a feeling that Zverev might have yet another gear to call upon.
Shot. I've seen him use the forehand line a whole lot. Look at that, just six winners off that side tonight. A lot of that to do with the defense of Dimitrov. It's been so tough to get the ball by. Second, Dimitrov not expecting it to come to his forehand side.
that second serve. Consolidates in good fashion.
Zverev leads 2 games to 1. Third set.
Bring in the step of Zverev with good reason. He was very close to being down 2 sets to 1.
Yeah, wasn't it just? Soon came back with interest. Dimitrov wasn't ready for it. He looks a little frail, doesn't he, at the moment?
A little early to be concerned, but do not want to go down a double break. Need to stay with it within the distance. Understandable that he has a bit of a dip after that breaker, but just to get it back together.
Yeah, the intensity has been so high right from the start.
15 across.
Perhaps he's just dipping here. And he's in danger of letting this slip. And his third set could be out of sight pretty soon. To get tough here and quickly. There's been a dip, isn't there? And Zverev knows it. A little look down the other end. The German takes command of this third set early. Zverev serving with a double break.
Being a shot maker, and if you have the wheels that he has, they allow you to transport yourself and create that kind of shot that some people can only dream about.
Most people can only dream about.
Thank you.
serves working nicely. And ace counts rising. Still at 73% first serves for the match. Clean strike. But a clean set.
One shot makes down set point, second serve. Hit a shaky one, managed to stay alive. Won that long tiebreaker 10-8. Now with a comfortable lead in the third, and Dimitrov hoping for this set to be over and see if he can come back in the fourth.
Not looking right on his own. Just got to try and find a way to himself back in a better headspace here. First ace of the set. Hope for him.
Zverev leads 4 games to 1.
Encouragement.
One set. Good news for him. He held serve. He should try and do that until the end of this set, no matter the result, so he can get in some sort of rhythm to start the fourth set. It'll be very difficult for him to come back in this one. But anything is possible, as we have seen here today. What a match.
Thank you.
lost 3 points on his own deal in this third set. He lost out in here 2 years ago. He lost to Djokovic, you remember, in the semis. Incredible match that was in five.
Legs just don't seem 15, to be quite 15. There as they were for the first 2.5 hours. Sometimes you can get that back, you can get that second win, but Dimitrov did a lot of running for those first two sets and a huge mental effort on his behalf. You can just see Zverev took 15, 14. His legs. So it seems at this point.
And he's been merciless in this third set. He's not let him in with a shout. To the set, one that Alexander Zverev completely dominated again. A look, a long stare down towards his opponent. He seems to have him right where he wants him.
Thank you.
Walking it to the ball there, and when he gets to the white one, just no explosion whatsoever to come back.
Thank you.
ball striking.
13-15.
So he might be taking a few more risks, mightn't he?
We'll be seeing a few of those bolded forehands this set from this man.
Couple of sets. So much of the traffic has gone into that backhand side.
Sorry,
just keeps it moving. Start of this fourth set, and this next game has a great value for Dimitrov. Has to find some optimism from somewhere.
If you're not feeling 100% physically and you're just trying to sustain the match to see if you can regain power in your legs, this is a huge game. He's got to give it his all to stay within the distance of Zverev, who obviously feels very confident at the moment. We have to give him credit for remaining optimistic.
Yep,
being down a set and a break.
Kicking himself with that error. Best thing he wants to do right now is give Dimitrov some free points. Involved again, doesn't he? Just get a little bit of an emotional lift.
It's all to help him again at this moment.
Short.
Well, you like that angle. That it's easier to see their intentions when they're up close and personal with that camera.
Yeah, that's a good angle. I enjoy that, watching the sport down low. It's a good perspective, doesn't it? Shape, spins, movement. And a grimace as well from Dimitrov after that serve.
Grigor starts weighing in, should I keep going or not? Because it's not worth getting hurt with 3 months of the season remaining, and he really looks like he's laboring like that.
Desperately trying to cling on.
Thank you.
shorten the point, wasn't he, Dimitrov, by getting it off the half volley. And seemed to be a makeable volley, but just couldn't get there. Relatively slow second serve, and just guilty of smothering that one. Got his feet quite out to the ball in time. Zverev, didn't he? Just have that ball enough loft, hoisted it up there, forced Dimitrov to reset the point. Is he to run around that ball and use the ground to produce the power? That time got enough of that serve where he got a short volley, short return, excuse me.
Feels like he's kind of clinging on there, doesn't it? His fingernails. Try to keep this alive.
Smile from the Bulgarian. That was a shot that he was rock solid for the first couple of sets. Look at the unforced error count. Kept things tight, Zverev in particular, in the last couple of sets.
Really laboring physically at the moment, with a big mountain to climb in front of him.
Of this match has all dissipated, isn't it? As a competitive contest, don't really feel like it's much left in it, to be honest.
It was so intense for the first 2.5 hours. The crowd was electric. The guys were pulling off incredible shots left and right. Very high level of play.
First service.
There it is again. There has been some issues with the let calls this first week.
So we've got three Americans in action tomorrow in the men's draw, haven't we, in that bottom half. That's incredible. Two of them playing each other. Four Americans, sorry, excuse me.
Big chance there'll be one in the semis.
Tommy Paul, Ben Shelton, Taylor Fritz. Francis Tiafoe. Zverev. He will be into the last 16. Something that didn't look likely for quite a bit of this match. Nearly out of sight here. The end of set two proved to be a very big plot point in this match. Dimitrov's not really been able to find a way to recover.
Dimitrov passed very well in those first two sets.
14-15.
It's a good sign of things to come for the Bulgarian. Zverev won that first match in straight sets, lost a set to a fellow German Altmaier in the second round. Looking strong physically. Manages to close this out. He'll be facing Jannik Sinner for a spot in the quarterfinals. As temperatures are expected to rise inside and outside the courts for week two.
Have crept in, first serve percentage is dropping. He's still out there.
Well, not his style.
Tired from matches. He's really suffering. So she has seven, and the crowd tries to help.
Still a fair few out there that have got him. Right behind him.
Oh, Serbia's man. Son seemingly on his last legs here. It a little bit short. They're still behind him, and those that have enjoyed this contest want to see him find a way to pull a path back into it. It's a big ask. Himself together emotionally well tonight, Zverev, isn't he? It's been very stable. Very strong between the ears.
He's looked strong in the legs. Talked about all the work he's put on the off court after that grueling injury. And it really shows.
It certainly wasn't easy those first couple of months of the year, were they? January, February. We're near his best tennis really until the on a springtime. Talked about how he was playing well in practice but just couldn't convert it into matches. This would be a big hurdle to overcome. Closing in on a 4-set win and a place in the last 60. Had a brilliant couple of sets, but was all she wrote. Not being the same player in the third or fourth.
Off the legs for that serve. I just hope he does not get injured at this point. Having a resurgent year.
Yeah. It's been a good year, isn't
yes,
it?
Yes, she has.
Wins wise, he's had more wins this year than he has, I think, in five seasons. Wins on the year.
Back up into the top 10, just adding points at this point last season. He was not competing after that injury in Roland Garros. Yep.
There's nothing left. How much of this do you think has been injury, Nico, or how much is it? Do you think this is down to the leg, or is it a little bit of a mental drop as well? Where's the balance there, do you feel?
I think the legs are just not there. Yeah. Mentally, he's strong enough to be able to compete. The problem is he just has no push off the legs. I don't know if it's an injury, because he did take an injury timeout. I guess we'll find out at the press conference in a few minutes.
Yeah.
Gentleman, he's pumped.
Just having a look at the head turn actually against Sinner. Played here actually 2 years ago. Zverev won in straights. The last time they played was in Monte Carlo last spring. Remember it well, and all the way, 7-6 in the third, in fact, and Zverev was able to win that one in a final set tiebreak.
Moved away from the German. Last throw of the dice here, maybe. well tonight, isn't it?
He's greatly improved in that area, and you pointed out the toss a little lower makes it look like he's in rhythm a lot more.
Leading, to be honest, he kept things so watertight for a couple of sets. And this has been a match of two halves.
In New York.
Couple of titanic sets to start things off. The second set tiebreak proved to be oh so pivotal. It's the German who prevails and moves in to week two.